Well, welcome to the San Paolo Stadium here in the heart of Napoli, the home of the town's football team, but this week dominated by the best student athletes in the world. Now we come to our first final of the evening, the women's 400 meter hurdles. There she is, the champion. Different kind of pressure when you are defending your title. However, she won the European under-23s 2 years ago. It was a breakout year for her. Now she needs to consolidate. So where we get then a clean start for the final of the women's 400 meter hurdles, and they hit the first hurdle in a line together. Very even start. The champion Colorunzo now just going off a little steadier, and it's Van der Velde who's just got a couple of meters out of her, going down the back straight with 250 meters to go. Van der Velde at the moment, but here the Italian now starts to kick in. She really starts to, that last 50 meters, she's really coming, and now she has the lead. The crowd are rising. Colorunzo looking to take the title for the second University Games in a row, and she has the lead. Van der Velde has work to do. She is the nearest of the pack, but it's going to be a clear victory here. What a run this is by Ayamide Colorunzo, and what Joanna Linkovic couldn't do 2 years ago when she fell to this woman in the final. No one is going to stop Ayamide Colorunzo from retaining her title. What a dominant piece of running that was. It was never in doubt. From 250 meters, she just decided to put her foot down, and that was it. By the time they reached the next hurdle, she was clearly in front. What a brilliant strategy. She can't believe it now, but that can't have gone any better than her coach had envisaged for them when they were talking about it last night. Well, Van der Velde looked like she did come across the line for silver medal position. She went off the quicker. But Colorunzo, well, that was the most dominant piece of running that you're going to see over one lap hurdles. And now the tears do come, the realization that the plan worked perfectly. You can see here, Van der Velde just went out quicker, had a slight edge on her here. That had grown a little bit further by the time they reached the second hurdle. But when they came down the back straight, and by the time they came here around the back bend, Colorunzo had already taken back that advantage that the South African had gained on her and turned it into her own lead. Total concentration, total relaxation, and total confidence in what she was doing. And look at this. And she was able to almost just jog to the line, really. That is a massive victory. 6 meters at the end was the difference.
The final, very interesting and fantastic for Italy. Argentina 53.75.
There it is then, confirmation then. 54.75. About a second outside of the Universiade record, but the gold medal for Colorunzo ahead of Van der Velde for South Africa and Ewell, who took a clear bronze medal ahead of Maria Mykolenko of Ukraine.
1500 meters, man. And now we go back to the 1500 meters on the track.
So where we go then, 3 3/4 laps of the track to see who will win the metric mile title here at the World University Games. So straight away, going to the front are the two Algerians, as El Hussein Zoukane, the 23-year-old who went to the World Youth Championships in 2013, and his compatriot Abdelrazak Kelaili, a little bit younger, 22, and didn't get out of the heat of this event 2 years ago. Well, you can see they're not going along very fast. It's a pretty pedestrian pace that they are setting at the moment.
It's another
So this rate is going to turn into an 800 metres. Nobody really wants to go in front of the two Algerians who have basically created a roadblock across lane one at the moment. Well, North Africa have great memories of this. He might not have been Algerian, but Said Awita of Morocco back in 1981. It only feels like yesterday for me that Said Awita was running in his pomp. An Olympic champion, world champion, world record holder. It's only when Morsely came along that he was knocked off his perch. And then, of course, Hisham El Gharouj took over from him. Now it's a lot more open than just the North Africans in 1500 metres. But at the moment, they really do not want to go in front, do they? They're queuing all the way over into lane three now. The Belgian, Steen Beyten, now moving out. The 25-year-old who went to the World European Juniors and didn't get out of the heat there in 2013. He thought about going in front, and there he is, right at the front in the black, the yellow and the red of the Low Country, Belgian. Well, they're thinking about it. The British athlete Michael Wilson now, 23 years old, a personal best in the semi-finals of 3:43.19, and he's trying to move up onto the shoulder now of the front two. Still the Belgian who is leading, and a problem there for Abdelrazak Khalili, who looks though he might have stepped on the wrong side of the curb there. He was the third fastest man into the third, and he's had another problem there. That's twice that the Algerian has nearly gone down. Belgian keeping out of it. He still leads at the moment. And now the action will really kick in as they head towards the bell. It's not the fastest by any means. It's going to be lucky if they get inside 4 minutes. But it is all about gold. So far, the Belgian, Steen Beyten, still has the lead. He has it for the last 800 metres. He has pole position. They're queuing up behind him, though. So many of the field still in contact. The Ugandan is just drifting off the back, Emmanuel Isuje. So there'll be no African success from East Africa, at least. But Khalili, who's nearly fallen twice, now beginning to go backwards by the look of it. Zoukane moving well. But the pole is looking threatening as well. Michael Romis as they come round the bend. And it all comes down to this far thing, and here he comes. I thought the pole was in a good position, and it looks like Romis is going to come through and take the gold medal. Poland have their second gold medal of the World Universiad on the track, and that was a perfectly timed run from behind. Jan Fries looks like he was in there as well, man who took a fourth national title this year for the Czech Republic. Well, it was always going to be a burn-up. It was so slow. 3:53.67, they did manage to get inside of 4 minutes in the end. They had to. They last 400 metres, easily the quickest. Well, that was a marvellous run. Minor medals going to Finland with Jonas Rinne, who got the bronze behind Jan Fris of the Czech Republic. The victory going to Rozmis of Poland. Well, we've just seen one Polish victory on the track 2 years ago. It was another Pole that took the flat 400-metre title in Taipei. Malgorzata Hołob of Poland. So then, Brosiek in one, Klimiuk in two, O'Grady three, Azevedo in four, Moran Erohon of Mexico five, Shida the favourite in six, Price in seven, and Melnik in lane eight, the final of the women's 400.
And that was a good start for
and
the
away we go then. The start is clean and good, and they head off round the first bend. Leni Shida just getting off to a steady start at the moment. Inside her, the Mexican Morad Eleron has had a flyer and is already up on Maddie Price. Maddie Price herself, though, is also racing well. At the moment, though, now here comes Lenny Sheeda. She's starting to turn it on with the 200-meter mark just passed. Inside her, though, Morad Eleron is also going well. Maddie Price is just beginning to struggle, I think, but the Mexican is absolutely flying. In lane four, she's going to have it as they come round the bend at the moment. But here they come then. And inside then, it's going to be a clear victory. Eleron is trying to get there, but here comes Sheeda. It's going to be right on the line. Is it going to be Sheeda? No, it's going to be the Mexican. What a victory. Paula Morad Eleron absolutely nailed that race. She put her colours on the mast there, going round the final bend and then hung on down the straight. And after the national records falling for the Ugandan in both the rounds, I did wonder whether she had shot her bolt already. She tried her best and she was coming back, but that last minute lunge, the last second lunge, gives Mexico the World University Games title. Sheeda takes the silver medal in 51.64, 0.02 of a second behind the winner. And it's Amandine Brossier of France who takes the bronze.
So now we see the official results of my women's final 400 meters appearing on the scoreboard. Paula Morán-Eleron of Mexico, gold medalist of Universal Games in Napoli. Well, congratulations.
Just a couple of tenths outside of Morán's, Eleron's personal best, but she won't care about that. That was all about victory. And having picked up a silver medal as part of the relay squad last time out in Chinese Taipei, she's taken the individual glory herself here in Naples. Well, Sheeda will have to make do with those two national records she set through the rounds and a silver medal to go with her, but maybe she just overdid it slightly in being fastest through both of those rounds into the final. Nevertheless, a fine accomplishment for her, and she too will develop. Morán, though, Morán, only 22 years old, seventh in Taipei 2 years ago. And this year's Mexican national champion at both the flat and the hurdles, picks up the World University Games gold medal in 51.52 ahead of Lenny Sheeda, 200s behind her, with Amandine Brossier beating Tatiana Melnyk quite comfortably to the bronze medal. The 800-meter final for the women.
On your mark.
Away we go then, two laps of the track. Big favourite here is Katrina Bissett. If she doesn't win this, then it will be a major surprise. Bissett set a world-leading time in April at the winning the university championships, the Australian ones that is, in 1:59.78. Set her up beautifully for this year, and it's really put her into the running as well for the World Championships at the end of September. Very late for the World Championships this year. It makes it very difficult to peak because the summer is so long. At the moment, though, it is Dorcas Ajok, the Ugandan, who is leading them out, but the two Australians right there with her. No surprise to see the short hair of the favourite, Bissett, right on her shoulder in the perfect position. Morgan Mitchell just a slight further back, two women between her and the front two. They reach the bell in a very swift 59 seconds. They've taken this out a lot quicker than the men took out the 1500 meters, that's for sure, in relative terms. Ajok now put under pressure. Brissett beginning now to get impatient. She's still there though. She knows she's got the speed, but she's got to watch out because Herring of Germany is trying to come round the outside of her. The big, tall German now takes it on, and Bissett has gone backwards and just got clipped a little bit there. She comes round Ajok. Ajok also gets a little bit clipped. This classic 800 meter running. Here comes Bissett there, lengthening her stride. She might be the shorter of those two athletes, but she's still going. Westaway of Canada now making her move. A jock going back as well. They're all jostling for position. Bissett coming away, though. The favourite for gold is delivering. They're not getting lost completely behind her, but Bissett will come away to take the gold medal for Australia. Bissett takes gold. Herring takes the silver for Germany, and Ajok picks up another minor medal in bronze. 2:01.2, that's very fast. Good time here at the University Games. But again, Bissett can go faster than that. She's done it already this season. It was back in April. And being Australian, she has the challenge of having to go through the Australian summer season and then transfer that into the Northern Hemisphere summer season. And that Northern Hemisphere season has been extended even further for the first time. Even the Diamond League finishes before the World Championships this year.
Australia, the winner and the champion of Summer Universal Games.
Well, Bissett, she allowed the others to go off fast in front of her, but the fourth fastest Australian ever to run this 800 meters event, qualifying her for the World Championships in one race. Just bided her time, had to get over a little bumping and boring going around the back straight and the bend of that second lap. And the woman who recently won the Oceania Championships just before coming over here took that in Townsville, which is a good 1,500 kilometres up the Queensland coast from the Gold Coast that hosted the Commonwealth Games last year. She beat Angie Petty, a former Universiad champion, incidentally, to take that crown. Morgan Mitchell, too, was in that race. Morgan Mitchell unable to medal this time around. But the big favourite in the women's 800 metres, Julie delivers. Brilliant running. Gold medal for Australia. Katrina Bissett in 2:01.02 from Christina Herring of Germany, just behind her, and Dokuz Ajok, the perennial medalist at the World University Games, picking up the bronze.
And while we're watching the final,
as we head over to the track again, and the final
to the track again
of the men's 400 meters.
Final of the afternoon session at São Paulo Stadium, men's 400.
This was the gold that was won by one of the world stars of track and field already, Lingelin Santos of the Dominican Republic. The man who took the 2012 Olympic silver medal and won this title as the reigning Pan American Games champion as well. Came ahead of Ioannis Leske of Cuba and Rafał Amelka of Poland. And there's a Polish man in this as well with Wiktor Sowała. Title that went to the great Alberto Wantarena of Cuba. This was his first big win. He wasn't the only athlete to win big at the Universiade and then go on to become a legend in athletics generally. On the outside then, in lane 8, Noaki Kitatani of Japan, former World Junior Championship finalist. Danilo Danilenko of Ukraine, 4 years older than the Japanese at 24. First individual global championship final for him. South African Gardeo Isaacs, just 20, won his first South African national title this year in Germiston back in April. Natsuki Kawachi of Japan, the second Japanese, again a first major championship for him, with Mexico's Valente Mendoza Falcon, 22 years old, again a debutant. Kazakhstan's Mikhail Litvin, the 2019 Asian Championship bronze medalist. He is seventh in the final 2 years ago here in the Universiade. Cheikh Tidiane Diouf of Senegal, another debutant in a major championship. And on the inside, Sowała of Poland, part of the relay squad that won silver at the European Under-23s 2 years ago. Passes through to the final was the Mexican, Mendoza. He goes in lane 4 as a result. Litvin, though, wasn't that much slower. It was a personal best, though, for Mendoza Falcon. You need your PBs, really, to come in the finals. Away we go then. The championship record was set by a Nigerian, Clement Chukwu, back in 1997. Can the Senegalese Cheikh-Tidiane Diouf replicate something here? He's got off reasonably well, but he's being tracked down by Sua in lane one. On the outside, though, it's the South African Gardeo Isaacs, who has the lead, I think, as they head past the 200-metre mark. He's been tracked by Mitsuki Koauchi of Japan in his first major championships, and at the moment, Mendoza Falcon is struggling somewhat. Here comes Gardeo Isaacs then. It's South Africa's to lose at the moment, but Litvin on the inside there of Kazakhstan is challenging, and look at that, straight through the middle. Mendoza Falcon ambushes them both on the line. What a last 80 metres by the Mexican to take it in 45.63. Another personal best. Well, we said you need your personal best in the final, and that is exactly what Valente Mendoza Falcon has delivered there. What a triumph of timing that was. Beautiful judging of the pace through the two halves, the first 200 metres and then the second 200 metres. And like Christina Hurrigu, the British star who took the 2008 Olympic title, Mendoza just tracked them down in that last 100 metres, trusted the pace he had set out on, and he slowed down the least, overhauled them in the last 10 metres and took the gold. What a beautiful race.
Valente Mendoza Falcon, 45-63, l'argento per il...
Well, another nationality getting medals. Mexico the gold, Kazakhstan the silver. With South Africa and Isaacs, who perhaps went off a little fast on that first 200 metres and then couldn't quite keep it going. 45.89 for the South African, a tenth of a second behind Mikael Litvin. Here he comes. He's an ungainly star, isn't he? But a star nonetheless. He almost has a bent back as he runs. Doesn't look the most comfortable, but he certainly eats up the ground.
We'll stay for three more rounds to find out who is the champion. Still Samuele Ciro of Italy in the lead with 16.25. Mingxuan Liu of China with the second jump to 16.23, very close to the leading position. Alexander Melo of Brazil, 16.22.
So then, Mendoza Falcon takes the gold medal for Mexico in his first major championships. Perhaps a new star has been born here in Naples. Second place to Mikael Litvin. So after finishing seventh in the last final, he upgrades substantially in both time and position to take the silver. And Gardeo Isaacs of South Africa, well, the early leader, he makes do with the bronze medal ahead of Danilo Danilenko of Ukraine.